You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host, and I have a good friend here with me, Chris Cross and Stills from Southeastern. How are you?
I'm great, Mark. How you doing?
Good. You have a great job over at Southeastern. You deal with drama and music and television production, and I knew you before that.
That's right.
Okay. But there's always great things going on over at Southeastern. And full disclaimer, I'm on the school committee over there for anybody that doesn't know that already. And I'm proud of our kids. I'm proud of our teachers and our staff. We get Life is a Cabaret, that's my friend, right, on April 24th.
That's right.
Tell us about that.
So I've been working with the drama program at Southeastern for as long as I've been there. I've been there, this is my 10th year.
Wow.
And I'm incredibly proud of the work that we've done and how we've advanced the program there. And last year, we really started to experiment with not just making theater about the plays, but finding other opportunities to engage the students' talents. And we thought, and myself and the other theater teacher there, her name is Christy Redding, and we said, we need to do a cabaret. Anyone who doesn't get in the musical or doesn't want to do the show, we still need to find an opportunity for them to showcase their talents. So Christy and I put together this night of where the kids could pick the music that they wanted to perform. We made sure that we got all the legality aside and presented to the community. And we collaborate with the culinary department there to put out hors d'oeuvres. And it's a wonderful night for people and the community to come in and see the kids perform.
And it supports the program.
Yes, correct? That's right.
So it's a fundraiser.
It is a fundraiser.
Okay, you get tickets. How do you get the tickets?
So the tickets, you can go to sersd.org. And we have a section of the website for the Southeastern Players. That's the name of our drama troupe there. Mm-hmm. And you can buy tickets. You can also buy tickets at the door right now. We currently have a few tickets left. It's such a wonderful night. We did it last year, and we raised about $800 or $900 that went right to the musical and right to the program. And that's the idea, is the money spent at the cabaret goes right into what the program is doing in it. And it allows us to do as much as we can to move the program forward, to, you know, spend it on the set and the music and the rights. And plus, more important to me than that is it gives the kids an outlet to express their talent and to show their talent. And that's, for me, is invaluable. It's for the kid who might not have the courage to get up on stage and perform the show, but give them that 3 to 4 minutes to get up and sing the song that they love or perform the act that they want to do. And it's just, you have kids coming out of the woodworks who I've never met who want to be a part of this. And it's a really beautiful thing.
Maybe I would have, back in the day, been able to do that. I always did like the PR for the play or the behind the scenes tech stuff. Mm-hmm. I never got out in front. I can't carry a tune in my back pocket. So I did play a mean trumpet at one point in time.
But that's the beauty of it, is you nail it right on the head. It would be perfect for a kid like you, because we use the term cabaret and everybody thinks that it's just about music, but it's about performance. That's all it's about. So you could have gotten up there with your trumpet and you could have played. We have a girl who's doing an acting scene. That's the idea. Cabaret has come to kind of symbolize music, but it's any type of performance that a kid wants to showcase. And that's a beautiful opportunity.
Well, I'm looking forward to it. I got to talk to you about a couple of tickets myself.
Absolutely.
So this is like the precursor.
Yes.
And then there is a musical at Southeastern.
That's right.
The end of May.
That's
Tell us about that.
And we have decided to do Stephen Schwartz's musical Pippin, which is a brilliant, beautiful musical about a character named Pippin trying to find his place in the world. It has unbelievable music, and we have such a strong cast to it. It's been such a joy working on it. And I've been working on that with one of the history teachers at the school. His name is James Fernandez. Mm-hmm. And he, like myself, does theater out in the community. And he's such a remarkable talent to work with. I look forward all year to working on the musical, because it's the most team production that we do. You know, throughout the year, it's me doing the show, and then the musical comes around, and it brings together all these different people. So we have James Fernandez from the history department directing with me, and we've got Christina Maggio, who is an outside professional music director comes in and works with the kids, and Christy Redding working on the sets. And then we have just a caliber of kids that come out for the show that is incredible. And it always ends up being the most fun putting together.
Three dates, right?
That's right. It is May 23rd, May 24th, and May 25th at 6:30 p.m. Just like for the cabaret, you can go to sersd.org and go to the Southeastern Players page, and you can buy your tickets now. They're on sale.
And if you can't find it there, I'm going to promote it on my Facebook.
Absolutely.
To all my friends.
Absolutely.
And we can advertise it. This will go up quite a few times before the 24th, and we might recycle it again and put it up before the May 23rd, 24th, and 25th, and that's right before Memorial Day weekend, I believe.
That is leading us
right into Memorial Day weekend. So that's a good time to do it, and before you know it, it'll be the end of the school year, and we'll be at another graduation.
Oh, and yes.
You'll hear your voice at the graduation with all the names.
And it's funny, I had to make an exception so that I can go to graduation this year. I got cast in a show myself over at the Mansfield Music and Arts Society, and there's supposed to be a dress rehearsal that night, and I told them, I said, I have to go to Southeastern's graduation,
right,
and then I'm bolting right from graduation right over there to perform that night.
I think you're going to need a state police escort or a helicopter or something to get out of 106 because we boxed that whole corner in. There's no way. And there's exciting things at Southeastern as well. We are in the stages, and I don't want to jinx it or anything, but we're trying to build a performing arts center over there, which means we have to figure out a way to pay for it without assessing all the towns the money to do it. We set up a foundation, Southeastern Regional Foundation. We have a golf tournament. I'll bring someone back on to promote that, to raise money, because we've outgrown the Black Box Theater over there. And unfortunately, the Mass School Building Authority did not allow us to build an auditorium when we wanted to build it.
That's
when we were renovating the school. So now this will be our attempt to do it. And if you think about it, there really is a need in the area for performing arts venues. I guess you guys looked at all the plans, and we have enhanced it and added to the seating. Lou hasn't given us the price yet.
Well, I don't have that either, but I do want to take a second to address that. I'm very blessed because in the world today where the arts programs are being cut back, I'm always extremely grateful to be in a program where arts is being treated with importance and with reverence, with Mr. Loebs and yourself. The school committee has always been so supportive of the arts, and Superintendent Loebs has been so supportive of the arts, as has the administration of the school. I hate to brag like that, but it's such a beautiful opportunity. And I didn't know if I could talk, and I don't know how much I can talk about it.
About a minute.
But I mean,
about 10 seconds of it.
How much details I can talk about, but it's a really exciting development as we move it forward, and I'm very
fingers crossed.
Excited.
I don't want to jinx it. Well, thank you for everything that you do.
I'm looking
forward to the cabaret and to the play. I'm always a regular over there.
Yes, you are.
And thanks for everything.
Mark, thank you so much.
Good to see you. You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host. Stay tuned for more events, places, people, and faces right here in the City of Champions.